How's everybody doing? My name's Mike, and this is Mr. Clarence, and he is a one-year-old Wheaten Terrier. So I actually got him yesterday, and we just did our normal, introduced him to leash pressure to get him to kind of stand, you know, like this in my area. If you've seen my videos before, it's just where I let them hit the end of the leash. And what I'm doing is teaching them, when you feel that pressure, I want you to kind of look to me, or I want you to keep the leash loose like this. So he's actually doing really good. His first 24 hours, we're seeing a lot. He's calming down a lot. So there's a few things to notice that you can do to help this dog right away that I noticed. So if you can see his eyes, you can't, it's like there's so much hair that you cannot see his actual eyeballs. You know, I have to actually like look to try and get eye contact from him. So what that tells me is we need to actually trim the hair in front of his eyes, because that's going to help our communication. Dogs do not talk the way humans do, and a lot of times, you know, I see clients try to, you know, communicate by just talking with their dog, when in reality we want our body language and our eye contact to communicate with the dog. So if you notice, you know, he needs eye contact, can't do that with his hair in his eyes, and he also can't see our body with the hair in his eyes, you know, so he can't see us and we can't make eye contact. Also, it causes confusion when he's on the leash and he feels pressure and he can't like look at me because he has so much hair. So he's gonna, you know, he gets corrected, he's gonna look at me and he doesn't really know his whole surroundings. He's got a, you know, his eye, his vision is so restricted. So that's something we can do to help a dog like this, is you know, trim that hair away from their eyes, let them see, don't cut their vision off. So, and that's something you can bring your dog to the groomer and ask the groomer to do that special. So this dog is actually a very hyper dog. He had a lot of free roaming in the house. So what that means is the dog did not use a crate, didn't know how to lay on a bed and stay still. It would just go wherever it wanted in the house. The owners are an older couple, so, and even with a young couple, a dog has four legs, they can get away from you very easily. So this dog was using that to control the owner. So, you know, if you want to go down and grab the dog's collar, you kind of just, you know, back away. So day number two, we're working on getting him to sit for us. We want the dog to sit still and kind of chill. Sitting is essential for him to learn how to just hang out. So sit, we're gonna see how this works. I just put my fingers on his back and I'm putting a little pressure here. Come on, sit, boy. And this dog doesn't know anything. Good, there you go. Good boy, good sit. So this dog doesn't know too much. Heel, heel. You see how he kind of froze just when I was doing the pressure right then. Just telling him to heel and him feeling pressure, he froze because the dog has no idea what the pressure on the leash means. With the owner, this dog, even though it's kind of a smaller dog from what I'm used to handling with, he's very strong and he really doesn't know, you know, what to do on the leash. So he is just pulling, you know, in every direction. And to tell you the truth, I have no idea how the owners were holding on to him. And, you know, he's fought the leash, and I wish I could have got it on the camera, but when he fights the leash, all we do is we just stand still, right? Just stand still and just hold the leash in a way where he can't get me. So I hold the leash up so he can't get me here. And if they're really trying to bite you, you can just kind of spin, heel. You can kind of just spin in a circle like this and have the leash up so the dog can't get you. He actually did that when I was turning the camera on. So, you know, I had to sit there and deal with it, you know, and let him go through that. So that's why you're actually seeing a lot of submission from him right now. Come on, boy, heel. So again, we're gonna practice him on his sits. Sit. Good boy, good job, good set, buddy, heel. Sit, good, sit. So I'm gonna try and get him to sit a little bit longer for me. When I tell him to come with me, like right now, he's getting ready to break that. If I want to take advantage of it and have him listen to me, I can beat him to that heel. Sit, good, sit, boy. No, sit. See how he's kind of frantic and he's kind of, and you see how he's facing me and he's trying to make eye contact with me, but it's very hard with the with the hair, but you know, it's good for them to learn how to sit. And with a very excited dog, you can have them sit and stay sitting in one spot. No, no, sit. And just when he gets up from it, I just say, no, sit, and I put pressure on the leash. And we just keep repeating that and letting him know that's what we want. Heel, come on, boy. Sit. Good, sit. Now I'm creating distance, so he's learning to hold that sit. Well, I make a little distance. Good boy, good sit. Now he's actually, he seems to be fairly easy to deal with, but I'm telling you, in the owner's house, he was up. No, sit. He was, he's very hyper. Everything was magnified 100 times. Just bringing him here, just on the ride home, I could tell the dog was calming down for me using a shake can. Anytime he was getting too excited in the back of my truck, just boom, just use a shake can and he would calm down. And just providing that leadership helps him calm down every day, you know. So this is day 2. We think he's going to do real good. Good job. Good sit, boy. Good sit, boy. Good sit. Good job, boy. Good sit. Good job. Heel. Sit. Good. Heel. Sit. Good. Heel. Sit. Good boy. Good job. Sit. Heel. Sit. Good boy. Good boy. Good set. Good set. Heel. Sit. Good boy. Heel. Sit. Sit. No. Sit. So a dog like this too. Okay, buddy. So a dog like this, he benefits a lot from a stall chain. So just having a spot where he can be, he has to be supervised, but just putting him in a spot like this, no. Just like this will actually benefit him because he's so hyper in the home that he would, hey. He's so hyper in the home. That's my fault, get the grass out of there. He's so hyper in the home and he's allowed to have the whole house to roam around. What he's doing is practicing excitement. So if you allow him to practice that excitement all the time, they're just gonna be excited. Everything they do, everywhere they go, and you're going to have a dog that is tough to deal with. So a stall chain, just in 24 hours, I could see has helped him out a lot just because he's now limited to a smaller area, and they start to learn, okay, you know, I got 3 feet to work with, and I have a bed here. What should I do? And they look around, they look at my dog, and they see he's laying on his bed sleeping, and they just kind of start to, you know, take the hint. So we're going to be talking a lot about what to do with an excited dog with this guy. And rules are what's going to benefit the dog the most, is having these rules and boundaries that he understands clearly. Sit! You got to work with him on obedience right from the start. This dog would have benefited from doing it as a puppy, like all dogs. Good boy. Good sit. Heel. Heel. Sit. Sit. Good boy. Yeah, you're going to do good, boy. Good job, buddy. Sit. Good.